Introducing the ApiFix System from Kyan Medical, an innovative approach to soft tissue anterior cruciate ligament reconstruction that facilitates double bundle single tunnel technique. The ApiFix System restores biomechanics, significantly reduces technical demands, and provides active circumferential compression at the aperture. The procedure begins with the harvesting of the hamstrings or preparation of an allograft. Once the hamstrings are harvested, each end of both graft strands are secured with a number 2 non-absorbable suture in a whip stitch fashion. The prepared soft tissue graft strands are then passed through the openings of the ApiFix femoral implant. Once the grafts are seated in the implant, the whip stitch sutures from the ends of each are wrapped around the suture cleats located at either end of the inserter handle. The tendon bundles are then marked at the inferior edge of the implant, serving as a depth indicator when inserting the implant into the femoral socket. Additional marks are placed on the two tendons that will represent the AM bundle, one mark near the implant and another mark close to the sutures, to help with the orientation of the AM and PL bundles once inserted into the femoral socket. The tibial tunnel is drilled to the same diameter as the implant size being used. The femoral tunnel is positioned in the center of the femoral footprint, low on the femoral notch, 1:30 to 2 o'clock in a left knee, and 10 o'clock to 10:30 position in a right knee. Holding the inserter handle with the safety pin facing straight up, the implant is inserted through the tibial tunnel and into the femoral socket up to the graft marks. The implant is then rotated clockwise so that the marked grafts representing the AM bundle are placed in the posterosuperior position, and the unmarked grafts representing the PL bundle are placed in the anteroinferior position. Suture cleats should be in the 10 o'clock and 4 o'clock orientation in a left knee. Once the implant is positioned correctly, the safety pin is removed. With the pin removed, the white deployment knob is turned in a clockwise direction until it comes into contact with the purple inserter handle. As the implant is deployed, the fixation of the femoral implant is taking place and the grafts are actively compressed against the tunnel wall at the aperture. Once the implant is fully deployed, the whip stitch sutures are now disengaged from the suture cleats. The inserter handle is then released from the implant by pulling the implant release knob and then drawing the inserter handle out of the tunnels. The ApiFix femoral implant has a number of beneficial differentiating features. The system allows for circumferential graft compression, aperture fixation, complete separation of the AM and PL bundles to match that of the native ACL, high pullout strength of 1,253 newtons, and unparalleled ease of use. The tibial implant procedure begins by wrapping the sutures from the tendon bundles through the lateral slits and then around the cleats of the tendon expander. The tendon expander is then pulled axial to the tibial tunnel. This provides equal tensioning of the graft limbs and allows for ease of insertion of the tibial implant sheaths. For proper orientation of both graft bundles at the tibial aperture, rotate the tendon expander until the tendons representing the AM bundle are positioned in the anteromedial portion of the tunnel and the PL bundle in the posterolateral portion. Positioning can be facilitated by inserting a flat device, such as a Freer elevator, into the tibial tunnel between the bundles to rotate the graft at the internal aperture. The nitinol guide wire is inserted through the tendon expander into the tibial tunnel between the tendon grafts and into the joint space. The inserter is preloaded with the sheath holder and the tibial sheaths. The inserter, sheath holder, and tibial sheaths are fed over the guide wire into the tibial tunnel and inserted until the cortical engagement tabs are fully seated against the tibia in the 12 o'clock position, or 9 o'clock in a left knee, or 3 o'clock in a right knee when rotating the bundles to be anatomic. Once the cortical engagement tabs are fully seated against the tibia, disengage the inserter and sheath holder by pulling back the inserter along the guide wire. Next, the sheath holder is removed from the inserter and the tibial screw is loaded onto the inserter. The tibial screw and inserter are loaded over the guide wire through the tendon expander until the tip of the tibial screw engages the tibial sheaths. The inserter is then turned clockwise between the two-part sheaths to deploy the tibial implant, providing circumferential compression of the graft. Once the tibial implant is completely deployed, the inserter is disengaged and pulled out of the operative site. The guide wire is then removed.
The ApiFix tibial implant has a number of beneficial differentiating features. The tibial implant is constructed from PEEK polymer, a bioinert and radiolucent material with superior strength. The sheath allows for active circumferential graft compression while protecting graft integrity. The resulting fixation at the aperture provides a superior, rigid construct that allows for positioning of the AM and PL bundles to match that of the native ACL.